Hi, this is Sculpture and Ceramics, and I'm Sabrina Kalleen, and I'm teaching here at MSA. And I've been here for my eighth year, and we are in the middle of a pandemic, but we're still going, and I thought we could show you kind of in progress what the studio looks like right now, and what you can expect going forward when we're out of this. So in normal times, we would have all of our classes in here, a combination of Novato High students and MSA students, and I teach Sculpture 1, 2, 3, and AP. The class is not just a ceramics class, it's sculpture with an emphasis in ceramics, so we do a lot of different mediums, primarily clay. So students will learn a lot about the process of clay. They'll be doing things like hand building. They'll be doing things like throwing on the potter's wheel. And they'll also be doing different mediums. So there's an example of like carved pieces, carved sculptures here. This is all ceramics one, or sculpture one. And then they do abstract figures like this. You know, how to do slab work and how rolling things out and just pinching them, a variety of techniques there. Then as they move on, they'll be doing things that are extensions of all those basic principles. So if you continue on into sculpture two, you'll extend like modeling techniques that you learn in the beginning to doing more advanced kinds of modeling like this. We do wood sculptures with like little design challenges, and those are extended further when you're moving on to into classes also. For example, wire sculptures will start with a little you can go here, these stay far away. These are wire sculptures that are covered in paper mache, but then as you're moving on, we'll work with wire on its own as the sculpture with just the lines. Conscious of staying away from you here as we're moving around. There are also various different mediums that we use in the upper grades. And then there are some sculptures here that I'll show you. We have an AP student who's here working. So these are our beginning sculptures for this year. So this is, they've only been doing work for what, six, seven weeks, and they're starting to produce some really beautiful works. These are little face mugs, and they all take a different approach to this. They're learning the basics, but they're also taking it and getting it their own little creative twist. This is beautiful. I got some nice dreadlocks there. There's devil there, and this one is this is Michelangelo's David as a face mug. So there's a lot of creative freedom here, but they're also learning the basics of sculpture. And then there's a whole bunch of stuff I'm so excited that we can still do clay even though there's a pandemic. But then there's also a lot of artistic kinds of challenges, like how do you create metaphor in art. So it's thinking about not just the skills that they're learning physically with working with materials, but also what is art, and how do you make beautiful art, and how do you make it convey some kind of emotion or meaning. And that's pretty much it.
That's what my portfolio is about. It's uh-huh. More of like mechanized adaptations into organic structures. So he's kind of a play on the conspiracy theory that birds are actually robots controlled by the government. So he's kind of a humorous piece. But yeah, so his face is going to be, I've kind of made little details that should read as metallic once he's fired, like these little green things for like SIM cards, things uh-huh. to see in computers. He'll have like a little bit of a red eye, and then the rest of him is obviously very natural, very much like a regular duck, regular mallard. So yeah, this should read as more robotic, more cyborg once he's fired and complete.
Very cool.
Yeah, so.
Are all of your pieces going to be animals? A majority of them are going to be. I have a like a fish submarine hybrid that's drying out on the bisque cart right now.
Mm-hmm.
So far, of all my sketches, most of them are animal related, but there's one that's just a combination of skyscrapers and then redwoods, which is obviously not animals, it's a plant right. versus a structure.
Right.
But majority of them will be just based on my concept.
And how long did it take for you to come up with this concept?
I started thinking about it because I knew I was going to be an AP at the end of the last year.
Uh-huh.
And I've always been interested in animals. Like, as a kid, I was just obsessed with animals. So I thought it'd be really interesting to do how like modern era has taken from organic things and like the natural world and kind of improved and kind of made worse the things that we have now. So
Right. So this is a way for art to kind of imitate life, so to speak.
Yes, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Thank you. This is my third year.
And when you first joined, did you know that you were going to follow this as a path?
No. I thought I was, like, filling a credit because I needed to, I was originally in drawing and painting, and I needed to experiment in one MSA field that wasn't my own, and so I picked this one, and I thought I'd hate it, but I love it so much.
And what is it that you love about it?
I like working with my hands in a way that feels like making something real. I feel like with drawing, it was never, like, actualized for me, but now I'm, like, I feel like I'm putting something into the world, and that's, like, really nice.
And what is it like working with Miss Kalleen?
Very fun. Never dull. She's really helpful. She's really nice, and I've, like, learned a lot.
Great. And can you tell me a little bit about what the community of artists is like in sculpture and ceramics?
It's very close because the only other person in AP is Elle, so we're buddies in the breakout room. It's just the two of us.
Uh-huh.
And I have friends in sculpture, like sculpture 1, 2, 3.
Right, so when we're on campus, you're not just in a class alone.
Yeah, usually the classes are pretty full, so it's pretty fun. You meet people you don't think you'd meet because it's people from all over MSA coming into this one class, and that's pretty cool.
And I think sculpture and ceramics is a little bit different than most of our other MSA programs in that it's usually a mix of Novato High and MSA students.
Yeah.
And what's that experience like?
It's pretty cool. You get to see art that people who don't normally make art make. Uh-huh. And I really like that. People make really cool stuff and it's always surprising. And like critiques are really fun and you get to see what everyone made and like how different people interpret different prompts. These are actually a series of slab-built pots that I am going to collage on with found objects and spray paint.
Oh, fun.
And they're gonna be together in one little set.
What kind of found objects are you going to use to collage on them?
I like working with trash that I like accumulate in actual life. Mm-hmm. And my sister went away to college and I found a bunch of fortune teller fish in her room, so I'm going to make a pot for her, like, covered in a little pattern of, like, red fish.
Very cool. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing your finished art.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.